very well. I'm Sypha Belnades. I could pee in a bucket and tell him it's beer.
Sypha, he saved your life.
He's rude.
Trevor, join us. Witch!
No, I am a speaker and a scholar of magic. I serve no demon and I do no evil.
You never told me you were a magician.
You never asked.
Though I guess I now understand why it was you who went down into the catacombs to look for your sleepy god. What are you doing here?
I didn't ask you to fight for me. I fight for myself.
Fine.
I will incinerate you before your fangs touch that man's throat.
I thought I was your legendary savior.
So did I. But he saved my life.
You're a speaker magician.
Yes. And his goal is mine. To stand up for the people.
All I can do is try and make sure it doesn't get you killed, so you can see your family again.
That's your encouraging talk?
Or you get killed and they get eaten in the forest, so none of you have to be sad. How's that?
I was right about you the first time, you know? You are rude.
I've been called worse.
Oh, I'm just getting started.
I know how to be nice.
No, you don't.
I do. I'm nice to everybody.
Then why are most of these stories you've told me in the last few days about you arriving somewhere and then getting punched in the face?
That's because everyone else is a horrible piece of shit.
See?
What?
Such a merry band we are. I will find us a covered wagon and horses if you two can manage not to kill each other while I'm gone.
Oh, please. We're not children.
Open Sesame.
Was that an Enochian ward?
Yes. I know that language.
And his name was Trevor, with an F.
Trevor. I like that.
Oh, it's terrible.
Treff. Treffy?
Oh my god, no.
You are Treffy now.
Don't.
You know, for coming from an oral memory-based culture, you're very good with books.
It would have been a poor education if we hadn't been taught to read things to add to our memory stores. But I am coming to the conclusion that my people are idiots, and we should have written everything down.
But how much of it is useful?
Well, I do have questions about Trevor's ancestors. I discovered an entire box of spells about penises.
You're certain it was one of his ancestors? You didn't find it under his childhood bed? I am concerned I have thrown my lot in with a demented infant.
I imagine he has similar concerns about you.
I am also concerned that you enjoy him too much.
And what is that supposed to mean?
He is unreliable, emotionally damaged, and apparently very distracting to you while you should be focused on the task at hand.
Oh. Am I not working hard enough?
I'm being literal. I aged very quickly.
That may explain something.
What?
Perhaps you're just an angry teenager in an adult's body. Oh. Oh, this is Trevor!
What?
I have something!
When I say what, that doesn't mean I would like to ask even more questions.
Would you please? Oh, you're the most annoying. Just stop!
I'm coming up.
See? God hates me. I did it!
Where did you land the castle, Sypha?
Right on top of us. Oh, yes, I landed it on the surface, right above this underground space that's probably only held up by wood and dirt. Let's go. Well, I didn't want to leave it in there to melt and ruin all your beautiful books.
It seems damp enough out here as it is.
Doesn't work anymore.
You melted it.
I didn't melt anything.
No. We can't move this thing. Sypha broke it.
I did not.
You kind of did.
I do not break things.
So we agreed she broke it.
Oh, yes.
Since I met you, I've come back from a living death. I've fought demons in the city square at Greshit. I've stopped a raiding force from reaching Ardgesh. I've discovered forgotten spells in the greatest hidden library in Europe. And I've trapped a castle that uses magic engines to move from place to place and pinned it to the ruins of the Belmont home. Why would I want to stop now?
Go on.
And I don't want to stop.
Stop what, for God's sake?
This! What we're doing! And it's good for you too.
Okay. How on earth did you come to that decision?
When I met you, you reeked of piss, blood, and stale beer. You killed a monster largely by accident.
Hey, that took serious skills.
And then demanded alcohol before storming off like a toddler with a thistle up his back end.
Right. How does that even...
Shh! And now, in the short time we have known each other, you have rediscovered yourself, and you've grown. Today might be the first time I felt like I was talking to an adult man. You're better than you were when I met you. Do you know why I think that is? It's because you're doing what you were born for. As insane as it sounds, this entire nightmare scenario has made you complete. I think you should see it through. With me.
With you?
Yes. You could be my handsome sidekick. Or mascot. Imagine that. If you didn't talk much, people would think you were my deformed pet bear and throw you free food. Be well, my friend.
You too. Don't let that idiot get you into too much trouble.
Never. Well, maybe just enough trouble.
Just enough.